Hi, Tim Horschler with another version of Tim Talks here, New Voyager Trading, offering you information about the Kromsky spinning and weaving products. Today we're going to be talking about lazy cates from the Kromskys. We have two styles. It's your choice. There's really not a big difference in terms of how they work, but this one here in front we call the arched lazy cate. Here in the back, the vertical lazy cate. Both of these cates will hold three bobbins at a time, but you can work with two or three for your plying. They also hold bobbins from other manufacturers, so if you have other wheels in the household, these lazy cates can be used on a variety of different machines. We're going to talk a little bit about how you put them together and then how you use them. So let's start first with the arched lazy cate. So up first is the arched lazy cate. You have to put it together when you receive it. Pretty simple. You've got a rear cross piece, a front cross piece. The large hole on this cross piece has to be on the same size as the small hole here in the back. And you want to put the eye screw back in here, then a spring, and then this brake band over the top and forward to this tensioning peg. You've got three rods that go from one side to the other. Obviously you mount the bobbins on those rods. We suggest always that you put the brake band over the larger pulleys on the end of the bobbins. Large end, small end, put them all underneath the brake band and away you go. You'll use the tensioning peg to apply a little bit more braking action on these bobbins. So when you're going real fast, you need to stop. These brake bands will help you do that and also hopefully keep the tension on these bobbins equal as you go ahead and do your plying. And next up is the vertical lazy cate. You'll be putting this together as well. You've got a base plate down here. Here in the back you have two small holes for these eye hooks. You see that the spring is attached to the first one and then the brake band is led over to the second one. And then we're going to go up to the top to this handle. You don't ever want to glue this. This allows you to rotate it and put tension on the brake bands as you need it. So get these vertical posts in here, get this cross member, don't glue this. And then you can see we have kind of a serpentine route from the bottom bobbin to one side and then to the other to the next and then to the other up to the top. And you'll want to make sure you do that serpentine whether you're using two bobbins or three bobbins. So let's talk about now how you get these to work, how you're going to set them up, both the arch and the vertical, to get them to work as a tension lazy cate. Let me talk just a minute about the use of a tension lazy cate. It can be the Kromskys or any others. They all work the same. Some lazy cates don't come with a tensioning device, and that's probably something that you want to have, and the Kromskys have put it on for you. Here's the idea. You've spun yarn, you've maybe filled up two or three bobbins, and you want to ply them, two ply or three ply. Hopefully you spun that yarn so that the tension on the yarn as it goes onto the bobbin is pretty much equal, that you don't have any lost ends where you couldn't find it in the core, and you said, well, let me just go on. As long as you don't have any breaks, you're okay. If you do have breaks, just watch your tensioning lazy cate and be prepared to stop. But what you're going to do is put your bobbins with yarn on the lazy cate. Make sure over here on the vertical one that the brake band is serpentine, so you're applying equal tension to all two or three bobbins that you're using. Over here on the arch, they're going over at the same type of angle, so they all kind of tension correctly as you go along, but just turn your tensioning screw or turn your handle up here at the top to get the tension you want. You don't want these bobbins to unwind willy-nilly. It has to be controlled. You're going to be plying probably at a fairly fast rate with your treadling on your wheel. You want that yarn to come off evenly. You want all the bobbins to kind of rotate at the same speed, so as the yarn is going through your hands, the tensioning on the plied yarn is virtually equal from beginning to end. So you put your bobbins on the cate, You set up the tensioning system, you put a little tensioning on that spring so you're starting to expand a little bit, and then start your plying. And you can adjust initially as you go along, but you probably want more tension on the bobbins rather than less. And you do this a couple times, you look at what your plied yarn looks like, and you might need to adjust your technique, but it's not difficult. Remember, all the Kromski Lazy Kates have this tensioning device, so you do want to use it. Also remember, these Lazy Kates and the Kromskis will hold bobbins from other manufacturers, and that's a plus. So there you go, kind of a primer on Lazy Kates. They're not going to be so lazy to you because they're going to produce the type of plied yarn you want. If you have any questions, talk to your Kromski dealer. You can give a call here to New Voyager Trading, and we would be happy to help you. So I hope this has been helpful. Let me know if not. And I'm Tim with New Voyager Trading. Thanks for watching.